I've been here before.
Hey, welcome back to the Learn and Pray series. John here with the Reno Brothers Band. The song will be Undo. Yeah, Undo, A Rush of Fools. This will be the slightly more difficult version because it's played without a capo. Same notes, but different positions. It's in the key of D. That's it, let's play without a capo. But you have slightly more fatigue in playing and singing, if you play and sing, because, well, it's a little bit more difficult, but it is really close to the recording. So, hope you enjoy. Okay, in the intro of the song, you are playing in a D chord position, which is, placing your ring finger on the B string, 3rd fret, middle finger on the G, 2nd, and index on the E string, 2nd fret. And what you do is you arpeggiate for the intro. Use the pick or not. I like doing it with the, just plucking it. So you start off with the D string, which is the string I'm bending here, the B string here, and the E string here. So you just like this, and there you go. And then you do like a little hammer on with the index finger, and what you do there is and you lift up and you just repeat. Something like that. But with that all said, I mean, there's your intro.
Been here before.
Now here... in the verses, you are still in the D chord. You're in the D chord, which is the same chord that you was doing the intro with, and then you move on to the C sharp over A, which is placing your ring finger on the A string 2nd fret, and your index finger on the D, well, over the D, G, B, and E, kind of like that. It's difficult to play, but if you can do it, thumbs up for you. For those who can't, keep trying, and you still get a thumbs up for trying. So, it should sound like that. It's going to be difficult, but like I said. And then you go into like a B5, which is just your index finger on the A string 2nd fret, your ring and pinky on the D and G, 4th fret, strumming just these three strings, the A, B, well, D, and G. And you're placing your middle finger on the B string, right here, on the 3rd fret, which is sound like that, which makes it into like a B minor 5. So it should sound like this. Let's try to play that if you can. And all I do is just repeat that, and you've basically played the verses. Awesome. Okay, into the pre-chorus, well, back for a second, before I get into the pre-chorus, where it's in a line that's saying, standing at the door, praying you'll let me back in, let's see, which is right here, and then you slide down to an A2, well, John, how did you do that? Well, basically what it just did was just, sliding from a B minor 5 into an A2, which is just sliding these all your fingers down, keeping it in the same position, but sliding it down till this finger is about to hit the nut, which is this piece right here, and it's going sliding, keeping constant pressure on the strings that these two fingers are at right here. And sure, it should sound like this as you slide down. I don't know if you can hear that, but it's just sliding non-stop. You don't stop to and change those chords. And then you go to G, placing these two fingers on the bottom steel strings right here, like that, on the 3rd fret, and your middle finger on the E string, 3rd fret. Label me. Into A2, which is the same chord you just did. And then into a D. The same chord that it was in the intro. And then right before you get back to the G, you go into like a F sharp over D. Just doing the same thing you're doing here. And then you just place your index finger on the E string, 2nd fret. Into a G. And you strum here, go into an A. Turn me around. And just flow right into the chorus. In the chorus, same chords, different pattern. You're going from a D to a B. Or another shortcut is staying in the D chord position, but you're placing your finger on the A string, 2nd fret. And then you go into a G, A2, D, D, G. Just repeat until the chorus is done. It's after the second chorus and all, where it's going, you can undo what I become. You go into a F sharp minor, and which is placing your index finger on the G, B, and A string, pressing all three of those down, and placing your pinky and ring finger on the A and D string, 4th fret. Alright, there if you can see it. So pressing all the strings down, and not hitting the E, it should sound like this. My bad. And then you go into D. I'm sorry, G. You can go in a G like that, or you can go like sliding up from here. And then slide up like all your fingers 1 fret and place your middle finger on the G. Like that. Then slide back. And play G again, which doesn't have to be like this. It can be like this, whatever you like. And then go back to an A. Turn me around. Back into the chorus. Playing right here, I suggest playing right here to give that little, swell, I guess you'd call it. So, just do that. And then, right when it goes back to the And Forgiveness and Grace on the A chord, bang, comes back in or whatnot, you can start going crazy with it if you like. And continue with the song normal. So, hope this helps, and that is basically the whole song. We hope this video was beneficial in your training. If you'd like to, please check out our YouTube channel, Facebook, and MySpace. Upcoming events and all, keep up with the latest stats, what's going on. I like to say, we all like to say thank you for those who came out and supported us throughout the previous events and stuff. We love seeing familiar faces, so Thank you and God bless.
Yes. I forgive.